Hey guys, thank you so much for clicking on this video. My name is Chris, and let's talk about scary stories to tell in the dark. So with the Super Bowl being over, we were treated to three different TV spots, giving us a little more insight to the movie Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark. What I'm going to be doing here for you is breaking down a little bit more of the movie. I did do one update already. You can check out that video in the description or card right above me. But here we're going to be focusing on the different creatures or malevolent beings that show up in this trailer. I will say though, these TV spots are the only bits of footage we're going to get for a while now. The movie doesn't come out until August of this year, so that's still a long ways away, so don't expect a full-length trailer to give us a better understanding of the story until around the beginning of summer. Also, small spoiler alert, there is no 100% guarantee that these creatures or beings are going to be taken right out of the books and given the exact same origin stories. If anything, they just could be taking the designs and the illustrations from the book and then doing something new with them for the movie. So a few little bits of details about this movie. This will revolve around a group of teenagers who are trying to solve mysterious murders going on in their town. Zoe Coletti is the star of this movie and has also been described as the heart of the film. She's mostly fascinated with these murders because a long time ago, her mother was also murdered on Halloween Day with mysterious circumstances. From there, she'll get her group of friends to investigate a few things, and well, it looks like each one of them are gonna be haunted with their own versions of the Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark short stories. And with now looking at this footage provided to the trailer, it's pretty obvious how things are gonna go down. We know that this house, behind the scene image, is going to play a big part into the movie. My assumption is here is very early on in the film, they'll all be grouped together, go into this house, they discover something, are exposed to some evil presence, where now each one of the friends in this group is now marked to be haunted by this entity. And we see that in these TV spots because there is a different teenager being haunted by a different story from the Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark books. It sounds like from what this character says, it's your turn, that each one of them will be taking turns being haunted. So I think that's an interesting little thing, kind of like a little Final Destination thing with ghosts. Jumping off from that though, we did get a look at the poster, and the poster includes an iconic character, Harold the Scarecrow. Now his story is pretty basic. He is a scarecrow, obviously, on a farm with a farmer who is very abusive to him, which, okay, I'm sorry, I miss farming 101 where you're supposed to be very loving to your scarecrow. So in return, one night, Harold the Scarecrow decides to take his farmer, skin him alive, and use him as a scarecrow. Let me remind you that these are kids' stories, by the way. Just remember that as I describe each one of these stories. So it's pretty cool that he'll be involved. One of the next things that we see here is a TV spot titled The Red Spot. Now this makes it pretty obvious to know which story they're pulling from. But before going into that though, notice the atmosphere around her, that this girl is obviously in clothes from a different decade. Could this possibly be a younger version of the mother of the main character? If not, it's very possible that they're having some sort of homecoming dance or prom where it's themed to 80s wear or 50s wear. That would explain her outfit, but it could be that there's some flashbacks to be had in this movie. But the basic story from the book is that a girl one day gets a tiny little spider bite on her face. She tells her mother about it. The mother says, "Don't worry, it's just a bite. Don't scratch it and it'll go away." Unfortunately, the daughter decides not to listen, scratches it constantly, growing it to the point she finds out that it's no ordinary bite, that this spider had laid eggs inside her, eventually popping out a whole bunch of baby spiders from her face. And you can see that here from the TV spot, a little spider leg is poking out. That's gonna be pretty awesome to see when the full effects are done. And I know I'll be extremely freaked out because as much of a fan of Spider-Man as I am, I don't like me spiders. One of the next spots here entitled The Pale Lady has to do with the character of The Pale Lady. Her story is entitled The Dream. This is about a woman who constantly has a dream of this pale lady visiting her in a strange room. As evil as she may look though, she keeps warning the person that something bad is about to happen to her, that something evil is going to come her way, and warning her to get out as soon as possible. The woman has these dreams long enough where she decides to finally listen to them and leaves into a new apartment. However, when she gets to this new apartment, she realizes it's very familiar to her dream room. And little would you know, the pale lady is there waiting for her. Turns out she was not good at all. This for sure to me is gonna be one of the stories I think they heavily change, especially since you see in the spot that it's haunting a boy instead of a female. And I have a hard time believing that anybody looking at that thing is gonna take its advice when it tells you something evil is coming. Yeah, it is, and it's you. So I'm interested to see how they'll turn things around for her character in this movie. One of the next TV spots here is dealing with one of the most famous stories stories in the Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark series. Hell, it's even the cover of the main book, and it deals with the story of the Big Toe. The Big Toe story, I think, is another one that they're going to heavily change for the movie. It deals with a boy who is at his garden. When he's digging in his garden, he finds a Big Toe. He decides to take it to his mother, where in return, the mother will say, "Yeah, that's what we're having for dinner." The dad goes ahead and splits it three ways for the family. They have a nice meal, and later that night, the person who that toe belonged to comes looking for it. And that's the person we see here in this TV spot. Now, I don't think a normal family would want to eat a toe. If anything, it'll just probably be this character probably stole something from that house. Something that might have resembled a big toe, a rabbit's foot, anything of that nature. Probably the kid just thought it was cool and now the thing is back to collect it. And one of the last things here that is surprisingly not from the books. They are going to be adding new creatures to this world. And he's going to be called the Jangling Man. Now, since he is a new creature and there's nothing to go off, I can't really give you a story on him. I know very little about him, but being just from his name, Jangly Man, he's got some chains. Maybe he was a prisoner, locked away, wants revenge. I don't know. Something like that could work for this movie. It'll be interesting to see if anyone cares that they add a brand new character instead of just bringing someone from the books. I don't mind it. I think it's cool. And if it's a brand new character, it might be very important to the plot. What I mainly want to get across to you guys, though, is everything we described here and everything that was shown in this TV spots were terrifying, were scary, and most importantly, it was all PG-13. I know a lot of people are hoping that this movie will be rated R, that it'll be gruesome, that it'll be really pandered towards adult audiences. But we do have to remember, it's based off a kid's book, that these were scary stories for children, and they're gonna pander to that same thing because they're gonna also wanna sell books along with the movie. Not only that, but the studio would want people who are now adults that grew up on those books to take their children with them and experience it together. But anyways, guys, those are just my thoughts and giving you a little bit more information about this movie. If you have read the books, are there any stories that are not included in these TV spots that you would want them to include for the movie? Also, let me know your theories and what you think the plot might be for this movie. Anything and everything, please let me know down below. Be sure to like and subscribe. Follow me on Twitter at 3C Film Review. As always, I'm Chris. Take care.